the film really came to me as I was pregnant with my third. And I just felt that motherhood was this really mind-bending, complicated experience. A deep, deep transformation occurred in me around being a mother. And anytime there's something that's deeply transformational, I feel like that's something interesting to sort of create drama around. So while the film's definitely not autobiographical, it does sort of draw on to my nightmare fantasies about it. It's like that, to me, that's the artistic process. You take a little spark and you just sort of light a bonfire with it. So that's what I do. It is very taboo to talk about, and I think that's part of the problem, is that people don't want to talk about it. People want to sort of create this magical, beautiful halo around mothers, and there is so much magic and beauty, but I think it's scary to talk about these things, but I also think that's what's important. That's what makes it important.
This film's only possible because of the amazing cast. Can you talk about the spectacular women you assembled and, of course, Mr. Kit Harington?
Oh, I know. I was so lucky with this cast. Noémie Merlant, who plays the lead in the film, is just absolutely magnificent in it. And you're right, the film would be nothing without her. She's spectacular in this movie. She embodies this character with every cell of her being. And she goes to some really dark places that I think we haven't seen in a film before. And Kit gives this brilliant, nuanced, beautiful performance that I think is also really different from what people have seen him do before. So I'm really excited for people to get to know this Kit Harington, because it's magnificent. What made me choose Noémie? I had seen her in Portrait of a Lady on Fire. I thought she was absolutely amazing. And I also really wanted the character to be a little bit of an outsider on American culture. A lot of the movie is about how particularly American culture offers no support for new mothers, and it's very unique in that way. So I thought having a French lead would sort of shine a light on that.
So I play the character of Caroline, and I play Noemi's assistant. And as you know, Noémie is this famous blogger, mommy blogger, and I am her right-hand woman. And I just make sure that we are both running a tight ship. And when things start to fall apart, I am there to witness it all and see if I can get her back on board.
Can you talk a little bit about some of the quite intimate and quite profound themes that this story explores?
Well, the main theme is postpartum depression, and I love that it's told through this psychological thriller lens, which you're seeing from Noemi's perspective, from her character's perspective, and you're really seeing how things can go off the rail very quickly, and it's something that I was not fully familiar with until I read the script, and I started to actually ask some of the women in my life, does this happen? And they go, well, yeah, but you don't really hear about it. I mean, at least I haven't, and so I hope that the film is able to really bring that forward to the viewers.
And for a story like this that surely speaks to so many women, how important is it for women to take ownership of telling that story, specifically with someone like Bess in control behind the camera?
Well, I always say whenever I see that a playwright has written a film script, I completely jump on the opportunity to get in there first, because you know you're going to be in good hands, and that they are telling the story in such a deeply human way that speaks right to the text and what the characters are feeling. And also, I mean, when it's in a woman's hands, you know it'll come from direct experience, which I believe it did. And so there's no middleman. It's from the source to the source.
And there was one token man on set, Mr. Kit Harington. Can you talk a bit about what that experience was like for you guys and what you think makes him such a very special performer?
Well, unfortunately, I did not get to work with him directly. I worked with Noémie, but just from meeting him today, he's a dazzling guy.
It's an amazing script. I'm a new mother myself, and so for me, the experience of talking about the psychological messy aspect of that was something that really excited me, and also the fact that I was kind of living it with my new baby. I felt like the right project to do. The character has, without giving too much away, a lot of psychological twists and turns, which was exciting. And Noémie and Kit, and Bess, the director. Great. It's a no-brainer. Of course I was going to do it.
Talking about Bess, can you talk about what makes her such an exciting storyteller?
She's one of those dream directors. She actually studied acting at Yale before she became a writer. And she's such a sensitive, thoughtful, beautiful director. She's a dream collaborator and someone I want to work with again and again. So. I was so scared at first, but it was, I wanted so much to play in English. It was a very big challenge, but I had so much pleasure. Bess, like, I love her. She trusts me. She makes me confident. We talked, you know, a lot to, okay, just throw yourself into it and it's going to be okay. And I did. And actually, Bess speaks French. So it was, you know, I felt comfortable to talk about details that were, you know, not easy, because this role is amazing. She goes through a lot of different emotions, and it's such a gift. Like, for me, I feel it's an amazing gift she did to me.
Did you learn something from the film?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it is how... I mean, I knew a little bit about that. I really be careful with the social media. I know social media can be very important for a movement like Me Too, Black Lives Matter, a lot of... a possibility to express for a lot of people that can't. But at the same time, like for Instagram or things like that, you have always to show that you have a perfect like life, that everything is good. And no, it's you know, it puts yourself in a lot of pressure, and the others too. And I don't know, this movie talks about this, that things in life can be terrifying and not good, and we need to talk about these things. Yeah.
I've done a few little indies over the last couple of years, and I've really enjoyed that process. Like you say, having come from this kind of Goliath show, which got bigger and bigger and bigger, and then being on a Marvel film where the budget was sky high, there's something really lovely and reassuring about returning to a small crew and doing things that just, where it feels like there's just direct access for dialogue. I'm really proud. I mean, I haven't seen the film yet, so I'll see it today, but I think I'm really proud of what we did. It's important subject matter, and it's, I'm sure, done with excitement and a kind of thrilling kind of, a bit of a thrill ride as well. So yeah, it should be a really good film.
And to have it premiere at the Toronto Film Festival.
Yeah, fantastic. I love Toronto.